So, welcome to my student support system. In today's class, we will discuss about cholera. This lecture is in English, and if you want to study in Hindi, just click on I button and you will get link of Hindi lecture, or you can directly visit to channel my student support system. What is cholera? Cholera is an acute bacterial enteric disease, means disease of intestine, characterized by sudden onset of profuse, painless, watery stools, and that is rice water stool, nausea, and profuse vomiting early in the course of illness. In untreated cases, rapid dehydration is there, acidosis, circulatory collapse, hypoglycemia in children, and renal failure can rapidly lead to death, and its death rate is sometimes as high as 50%. Cholera is caused by a bacteria known as Vibrio cholerae. Vibrio means coma shaped. So this is coma shaped bacteria. Vibrio cholerae have two serotypes which are associated with the epidemiology of cholera. How it spreads? Cholera is acquired through ingestion of an infective dose of contaminated food or water. So we can say it is waterborne disease as well as foodborne disease, and can be transmitted through many mechanisms. Contamination of drinking water occur at source, means from where water is coming, during the transportation and during storage at home. Food may also be contaminated by soiled hands during preparation or while eating. Contaminated surface water and unsafe domestic water storage methods also results in extensive waterborne transmission of cholera. Beverages prepared with contaminated water and sold by street vendors, ice, and even commercial bottled water may have been identified as vehicles of cholera transmission. Incubation period of cholera is usually it is 2 to 3 days, but range is as early as 5 hours to 5 days. How you will identify cholera? Clinical manifestations. The clinical manifestations are profuse, painless, watery stools, means the number of stools are increased, and that is watery. And typical rice water stool is there, means pale, milky appearance of the stool. This shows that yes, there is this diarrhea is due to cholera. Along with diarrhea, there may be nausea and profuse vomiting early in the course of illness. So at this time, it is very difficult to control dehydration because patient is not tolerating ORS. Then pain abdomen will also be there. The client will be lethargy. Signs of dehydration such as dry mouth, sunken eyes, loss of skin turgor, irritability, and fatigue is also there. Then muscular cramps, low blood pressure, circulatory collapse, and the client may go into shock. Then hypoglycemia and renal failure can rapidly lead to death if it is left untreated. Diagnostic investigations. So typical physical examination, typical sign and symptom can give suggestion of cholera. Then for confirmed diagnosis, we go for stool microscopic examination and stool culture after taking rectal swab and sending it to the laboratory. Then this Vibrio cholera is identified. Treatment. Treatment with antibiotic is effective against cholera. Drug of choice are doxycycline, tetracycline, TMP, SMX means trimethoprim and sulfamethoxazole, and erythromycin. Adequate hydration with ORS if possible, if there is no vomiting, and IV fluids may also be needed. how we can prevent cholera. Even early detection and prompt treatment of the cases is the best strategy to prevent further spread of the cholera. Isolation. Hospitalization with enteric precautions is desirable for severe ill patients. Otherwise, it can be treated through in OPD. All soiled clothes and linen should be soaked in solution of 2% chlorine solution and maybe steam sterilized. Use of best possible cleanliness in food preparation and handling. Pay particular attention to the storage of salads and other food served cold. These provisions apply at home as well as public eating places. Avoid eating uncovered food or water. Use best possible milk hygiene practices such as pasteurization and refrigeration of milk. Health education regarding the importance of hand washing, suitable hand washing facilities, particularly for food handlers and attendants involved in the care of patient and children, should be provided. Means personal hygiene should be maintained. Environmental sanitation and abolishing breeding places of flies also good measure to prevent the spread of cholera. Health education regarding the importance of safe drinking water to prevent cholera should be given to the general public. Methods of water purification should be understood to all. Immunization with cholera vaccine is also a good method of prevention of cholera, especially in endemic areas. So students, for watching such videos, you can subscribe channel, you can like Facebook page, and for making your notes, you can visit blog mynursingstudents.blogspot.com. You can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and join Facebook group Nursing Notes. Thank you. Have a nice day.